Today, I want to talk about another major enhancement in Database Release 12c, and that's the new options for creating histograms. Just as a quick review, I hope we are all aware that getting decent SQL performance is all about getting accurate cardinality estimates. It's all about the cardinality. How does the cost-based optimizer generate cardinality estimates? It uses histograms. It uses histograms, giving it the distribution of data within tables. Accurate statistics are vital if the optimizer is to come up with decent execution plans. If the cardinality estimates are wrong, you are going to get inappropriate join orders, inappropriate join methods, inappropriate access methods. I strongly believe that 9 out of 10 of your fixable performance problems can be fixed by giving Oracle accurate statistics. So what are the improvements with release 12? Firstly, you can have many more buckets. In all earlier releases, the maximum number of buckets for histogram was only 254. That meant that if there were more than 254 distinct values in a column, the estimates were pretty imprecise. Oracle had to generate what was called a height-balanced histogram, which was a pretty crude technique. In 12, firstly, the number of buckets can go up to over 2,000, and that will give you an absolutely perfect estimate. Perhaps more importantly, though, for tables where there are more than 2,000 distinct values in a column, there are new histogram types. But one way or another, the optimizer will now have much more accurate cardinality estimates. So how do you implement this functionality? Well, enable the autostats task. Always make sure you're analyzing on a regular basis. Certainly for individual tables and columns, consider raising the number of buckets from default. Most importantly, do not interfere with the sample size algorithm that the gathering statistics process uses. If you interfere with the sample size, you will not get the new histogram types. Let's take a look at the 12c new features and see how well they work. I'll create a table, create table T1, select star from all objects, and see what statistics I have by default. Select column name, number of distinct values, how many nulls there are, what type of histogram there is, from user tab called statistics, where table name equals T1. And we get some useful information. Those of you who aren't familiar with 12 should be surprised already. In an earlier release, there would have been nothing. But in release 12, when I create a table with this syntax, some basic statistics are automatically generated during the table creation. But histograms, no. I've got no histograms created. For that, I need to explicitly request them. I'll gather statistics in a way that many DBAs will do. Execute DBMS stats, gather table stats. For my schema, table T1, estimate percent 100. I'm telling Oracle to look at the entire table, and that should give it as accurate statistics as is possible to get. I'm also requesting histograms on all columns that need them, for all columns size skew only. There's no point in building up a histogram on a column that has no skew. And what histograms do I have now? Frequency and height balanced. A frequency histogram means that as long as the number of distinct values is less than the number of buckets, the histogram will be perfect. And the default number of buckets and the maximum in earlier releases was 254. So if I have less than 254 values, I'm going to get perfect estimates. Height balanced histograms, that's when there are more than 254 distinct values, and Oracle has to combine several values into each bucket of the histogram. That's not going to be nearly as accurate. How accurate is it? I'll enable the autotrace facility and run a simple query. So my query, select count star from T1, where created greater than the truncation assist date, and note that the created column has 1600 values. Therefore, a height balanced histogram. We get back 95 rows, and here's the bad news. Oracle expected only 56 rows. Of course, I just have a very small demonstration data set here. But this sort of inaccuracy of about 40 rows, multiply it up to the real world, and it isn't 40 rows, it's 40,000 rows. This sort of mistake can totally distort your execution plans. Let us see what we can do with the new features. I'm going to gather the statistics again, but this time I'm going to remove the estimate percent argument. So execute DBMS stats gather table stats for my schema table T1, and then go straight to method opt for all column size skew only, and allow Oracle to use the auto sample size algorithm as it does the analysis. Having regathered the stats, let us see how accurate the estimates are now. Enable the auto trace and run my query. Much better, isn't it? By letting Oracle use auto sample size, we now find the estimate is much closer to reality. Why has that happened? If we look at the histogram types that have been generated, we'll see the answer. We now have hybrid histograms rather than height balanced histograms. The hybrid histogram algorithm is far more accurate. Notice it's imperfect, but clearly we're a lot closer to reality than we were before. Now, believe me, when you have real data sets with sensible volumes of data, the estimates you get from hybrid histograms are very nearly perfect. But what if very nearly perfect still isn't good enough for you? There is an alternative. You can take control. As an example, execute DBMS stats scatter table stats for my T1 table, method opt for all columns created size 1024. I've chosen the one column I'm using in my predicate, which has about 1600 distinct values, and I've said, build me a histogram of that with 1024 buckets. That's four times as many as was possible with the previous release. And now let's see how accurate the histogram is. Perfect. The estimate is now spot on with reality. It doesn't get better than that. What is the takeaway from this? 12C has new histogram types, hybrid histograms and top frequency histograms. I haven't demonstrated the top frequency histogram today, maybe we'll do that another time. These two new histogram types are far more accurate than the previous height-balanced histograms. However, you must use auto sample size when you gather statistics. If you interfere with the auto sample size algorithm, as I demonstrated, you do not get the new histogram types. Second major feature, the maximum number of buckets you can have. You're no longer constrained to frequency histograms of only 254 buckets. You can now go to 2048 buckets. And that's going to be a huge advantage for many sites. The conclusion, you will get, following your upgrade, more accurate cardinality estimates, much better performing SQL. And this should be a major driver for the 12C upgrade.